So I've been playing with this Shelly RGBW2 LED for a few weeks now without putting out a good video, so sorry about that, but hopefully this will make up for it as I'm going to show you what I've done with this relay, and afterwards I'll show you how I did it. So if you want to do something similar, I think it's kind of neat, and my kids actually enjoy using it and go out of their way to use it because they think it's fun. So basically, you may notice that I have an echo and my LED strip over here. And in our house, we have a couple boys and they love playing video games, and we really don't want them playing video games all the time. I'm not anti-video game, but I'm just anti spending their entire day on it. So we've come up with a chip system. They get a little poker chip when they accomplish certain tasks like achievements, their morning routine or evening routine, and that chip can be redeemed for 30 minutes of screen time. And so I'm using the LED strip as 30-minute as the 30-minute timer for screen time. And so we can put this in the living room, and when they initiate it, it will turn green for 25 minutes, and then for the last 5 minutes, it turns yellow. Then after that, it turns red. And 5 minutes after red, then it starts flashing red. So if we see a red, we're like, oh, yeah, you're not supposed to be playing video games right now. Why don't you go ahead and hop off? And then if we go in and we see that it's flashing red, then it's like, wait a second, how long has that been flashing red? But the cool thing about this LED strip is if we walk in and they're playing video games and there's no lights on, then we're like, hey, you didn't set a timer, you need to stop now. So it's just kind of a fun way to add accountability and responsibility to the to playing video games in the living room. Maybe I should make one of these for actually recording and producing videos for my channel. But anyway, without further ado, I thought it might be fun for me to give a demonstration. And I'm willing to take one for the team and play 30 minutes of video games for you guys, hopefully sped up a little bit. So, since we use these for their chips, Arwin, turn on the chip strip. Sounds like I got 30 minutes to play. Oh, I have another camera. I forgot about that. I'm also playing with a Blackmagic ATEM Mini Pro and testing that out. It's not mine, I'm just borrowing it, but man, it's fun. Camera one, camera two, camera one, camera two. Okay, this counts as playing, right? Like, maybe I could just do that for 30 minutes. I'm just kidding. So I'll go over to my PC. Picture in picture, it's crazy. So I am going to check out Minesweeper on Windows 10. Uh-oh. Don't know if you can see this, but these are yellow LEDs because I don't have much time left. I only have 5 more minutes of Minesweeper. So that thing will turn red soon enough. Uh-oh. I'm out of time. So, yeah, that's the whole process. I'm gonna try and finish this. I'm gonna just guess. Ho ho. Okay, so that didn't take long, but you get the point. I can reduce the amount of time that my kids are playing on video games. It's kind of fun because this is on the entertainment center. It lights up. It's kind of a neat thing. After a while, it will start flashing red. And so I'm just going to walk through real quick a couple of concepts. I'm not going to go over exactly everything that happens because it is a little more... kind of beyond the scope of this particular video, mainly because it's almost midnight and it's 55 degrees out here and I'm a little cold. So drinking some tea, herbal tea, help me sleep, hopefully. It's still super hot. So we'll go over here to my Node Red. Basically, the chip button right here is a toggle switch. So if I double click on this, it's the input boolean chip. So I'm gonna cancel that. So if I go over to this touchpad dashboard, it's this big use a chip icon. And if I go over to my normal overview, like this just is a simple toggle switch. And so that's how I was controlling it at first, because I didn't know how to get it to integrate with the Echo. Because this is a fourth generation Echo product, I think. So some of the default built-in Node Red little plugins didn't work the first time I tried them. And then I learned, oh, there's this add-on called the Amazon Echo Hub. The Amazon Echo Hub kind of acts as like a little... It feels like to me like a mini server to allow it to communicate with the Echo. And then the chip strip is the specific fixture for that. So it represents itself as a light bulb. That's why I had to say to turn the chip strip on, because it's an on off. I think you can control the color, like you can send other commands. But anyway, the whole point. The way this thing works is, can I control zoom? I can, check that out. Okay, so here is my flow or my sequence. It's really messy. It could be a lot better, but the concept is something triggers the initial countdown to start. And right now it's stopped. The final countdown has ended, and you can see the lights are flashing. That's because, hey, we've not only exceeded the 30 minutes, we've gone over the 5 minute grace period. So now I would just need to say, AON, turn off the chip strip. And there we go. And so what it just did was, it just, when I said turn off the chip strip, you know what? I have debug. How do I get these back? So if I look at my little debugger, so when I said to turn it off, it gave the payload of off, and on is false. So brightness is still full up, percentage is still 100%. Hue and saturation are whatever they were before. In fact, actually the RGB array is, I guess that's the same. It looks like red, green, and blue. So I don't know, that might actually be figuring something out. But either way, my voice command got converted to a turn off the light command. And then I have this switch. So there's my command. The debug thing here is just for what I just showed you. Then I have this little switch for is on. And if it's true, then go to the first thing. And if it's false, then go to the second thing. So the first thing, if it's true, well, first off, if it's false, if turn on is false, then turn it off. And to turn it off, I have a function that says, hey, the message payload is turn colon off. Now, it doesn't change the effects. It doesn't change the color or anything. In fact, if I were to use the Shelly app and simply power on the strip, it continues on. It's flashing red because that's what the current command is for that Shelly strip. So we're just checking, hey, if we said to turn off, then change the message payload to turn off and send that payload to the send LED strip command. And all the send LED strip command does is it says on the Shelly RGBW2 topic that I have, send it a command. And that's it. So there's no command in this. This is just to actually send whatever the current payload is. And that's what I changed in this function. So all we're doing this entire time is changing the payload and then sending it to the LED strip command here. So the first one, if it's on, if we said, you know, hey, lady in a tube, turn the chip strip on, then that would be true. It would come up here to the countdown. This first countdown is 1500 seconds, which is 25 minutes. And basically, when the timer starts, when it's on, this is what the payload is. It's turn on, effect is zero. So we're resetting the effect back to none. No effects at all. Red is zero, green is 255, which is 100%. And blue is zero. So this is just to say, turn the strip to green. And that's the message that we're going to send. And when the timer goes off, then we're going to switch it to yellow, which is red and green are both at 255 and blue is at zero. We're ignoring the effect right now. So then after that, I have a little, it sends the command to the LED strip so that, you know, whether it's on or off, but then I have a little switch here that says, is the current message payload red and green are full up and blue is nothing? Because if so, that means this would be the indicator that says, oh, we've passed that timer. Because at the end of this timer, it's going to turn it yellow. So if it's yellow, then it'll continue on. If it's not, then it won't do anything down this path. So then we do the same thing. We have a countdown that says, okay, we're going to set it to when the payload starts or when the timer starts, the payload is yellow. It just continues on what this previous one started. But then when the timer is over in 5 minutes or 300 seconds, then we want to switch from yellow to red. Okay, so now we're doing the exact same thing. Now we're saying, hey, if it's red, then I want you to start flashing it. So if it's red, then come over here to the countdown where the message payload, the timer on payload is just whatever the current payload is. We're not changing it. But the timer off payload is going to be effect of 3, which is flashing. So it's going to flash whatever the current color is. And the current color has to be red because that's what this little switch does. So these little checks are just, they make sure that whatever's happening on the other side of them is supposed to. So normally, if you didn't have these in here, the message will flow through the entire sequence all the time. And it's this that kind of blocks it instead of it, you know, being able to go through. So that's probably what took the longest time to figure out. And then I put these little buttons here. These are just for me in troubleshooting. I can click the little button and it turns it on. And I can just send a payload of turn off to here. Now, something to consider is even when I turn it off, whether that's through a voice command or this little button here, this is still running. So this timer is going to continue running until it's done and probably move on to the next step and then run the next one. So I did warn my kids, hey, if you keep turning it on and off, you're probably going to lose time because it'll just pick up where it left off if it's still in that first countdown. So this is really a rambly way of describing this. I'm sorry. I will go over more details if you need me to or if you'd like me to. This took me a while to kind of wrap my head around, and I'm not very good at describing it. So let me know if you have questions in the comment below. I'd love to answer your questions about this and go into more detail or figure something else out with you if there's something else that you'd like to see happen. Now, one thing that I know is possible, but I don't know how, is I can stop the timer and restart it, like reset it to zero. I could probably even make a voice command that kind of that used a brightness level in the voice command to change, you know, between different lengths of time for the chip. So like if I wanted them to have a shorter chip, they could say, you know, turn this on to 50%, you know, or something like that. There's got to be a way for me to pause and resume this timer. And I know that it's possible with Node-RED. But I mean, that's still a squirrel that I'm chasing. And obviously right now I'm not chasing it too hard because it has been several weeks since I've produced a video on this kind of stuff. And I'm going to work on getting better about that. This next video, I'm just going to go through all the different effects of the RGBW2 LED strip. And I am going to try and see if I can make a breathing effect using Node-RED. I don't know if that's possible or not. So if you're interested in this, if you have an Echo, I highly recommend the Amazon Echo Hub node in Node-RED. And I can't remember if that was already in here by default or if I had to install it. But if I had to install it, all I did was went to Manage Palette, Install, and I searched for Echo. And I think that it was Amazon Echo. The big difference is a lot of the existing ones, like the Aragorn Home Skill. Oops, never mind. That one, I believe, doesn't work with this newer Echo. And that took a while to troubleshoot. But once I added this, like the neat thing is, if I wanted to, I could go in here to I could just add an Echo device and connect it and then start doing things. And as long as I connect it to the output of the Amazon Echo Hub node, then whatever I name it, I can discover as a light fixture on my Echo just by telling it to find new devices. And that did take a little while. I had to pause and let it figure these things out and see it on the network. It didn't work like within minutes or within seconds, but definitely within a few minutes, it was discoverable and it figured it all out. So having a debug node that spits out the complete message object is really highly recommended because you can start sending different commands and watch them come through. For instance, if I bring this back out and we look at the debug node, then I could say things like Elrond, set the chip strip to 50%. Okay, so I just got two things. Okay, so I got on is true, brightness is full, And then I got another one on as true, percentage is 50 and brightness is 128. So I wonder if it always does that. Aomer, set the chip strip to 100%. So I just got a new one. Yeah, and that was just a single one. Now, I noticed that it's not on, and it says on is true over here, and payload is on, but it's not on. That's weird. Oh, wait, no, that still doesn't make sense, because this is checking for the property message on is true, and on is true. And so over here it says turn on. Oh, but it's already running. So this is already running. That doesn't make sense.
Isildur,
turn on the chip strip. Yep. So anyway, that's why it's kind of hard to figure these things out, because I don't know what's going on. I'm going to turn it back on. There we go. So it is green. It picked up where it left off.
LSR,
turn off the chip strip.
Estella,
turn on the chip strip. Ooh. Huh. So turning it off and on is not working the way that I thought it was. If I just trigger it. Yeah, it totally doesn't work. I'm going to say restart countdown if message is received while running and see if that works.
Everard,
turn on the chip strip. Aha, and it just reset the counter. Well, that's dangerous. So right now, we're below 1,490 seconds.
Some other elf.
Turn on the chip strip. I just reset it. Oh, that's dangerous. I won't tell the kids. Don't tell the kids. Thankfully, I don't think they watch these videos anymore since they're not throwing things at me. But that's a bug. So see, you know, this is why it's a fun squirrel. I'm still learning. Hopefully we'll get something working. In the meantime, I at least got to play with a fun video switcher. Laptop, camera, laptop, camera, laptop, camera. And it also does alpha keying, which is kind of neat. So if I was more prepared, I could have like bullet points up here. That's controlling an LED strip and using it as a timer to control the amount of screen time my kids have on video games when I'm not in the room.
Arwin,
what is your name?
My name is your host, the Craftsman.
So what kind of stuff would you like to see me try with this? Okay. I think my next project is probably going to be controlling the garage door with the Shelly Relay version 1. And I'm just basically going to follow the hookup description on that and just make sure that it works in 2020, even though nothing else does. But let me know what you think. What would you like to see? What kind of projects do you think would be fun to do with this? What would you do if you had one of these LED strips and the controller? Thanks again for watching. Let me know if you liked this video. If you'd like to see more like this, where I walk through some of the Node-RED things, would you like me to go in more detail, less detail? Do you want to see me do a marathon of Minesweeper again, or maybe Solitaire? You just let me know, and I'll see what I can do. I definitely want to pick this back up and not lose track of this channel, because I am having fun chasing squirrels.